I'm sorry, I've got the giggles. Let's try this again. Hey guys, it's Em. Today I'm gonna be sharing with you my snails and the story behind one snail in particular called Shrek. So without further, I'm so sorry, I can't.
I'm sorry, snails have faces and they just amuse me so much.
Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, because I have a ton of amazing videos coming up and I'm super excited about them and I want to share them with you. My snails at the moment are having a bath. I know that sounds weird, but you should soak your snails, and they are in a Delectable X mint chocolate chip soft scoop something or rather, which I did not devour all alone over the course of like two movies in one day. I have someone peeking over the side here. Oh, ew, you've got some grossness on your face. Come here. Ugh, lovely. Just grime on my fingers right there. Ugh. I'm wetting my hands because you should never really pick up a snail with dry hands. It can really damage their skin. Ta-da! This is Shrek. Oh, hello, is that you? I think you're a bit gorgeous, aren't you? I want to give you guys a really good close-up of Shrek. Hello, is that you? I don't really want to keep Shrek on my hand too long, even though my hand is wet, because it's just not good for them. So I'm going to transport him onto something which is quite state of the art. I would like to introduce you to my lettuce leaf over here. This looks like how you would receive some kind of trendy street food. Let's peel it open and oh, it's escargot on the go. So this is Shrek. Look, I'm just gonna put Shrek up to my face just so you can get a grasp of the scale of how big Shrek is. Look, ugh. Oh my god, you're huge. I have an urge to lick her shell, but I'm not going to because I don't really want to catch meningitis. This is Shrek, my huge female giant African land snail. I say female because she laid some eggs for me a couple of days ago, but in reality, snails can actually be male or female. They're hermaphrodites. They can change, chop and change if they're going to be male or female. So, you know, just because she laid some eggs for me the other day doesn't mean that she's always been female. I'm fairly certain that she was a male when she first came to me. Is that you in the camera? Are you going to be a YouTube famous snail? I think you are. She's rasping on my finger. You see my fingers under there? She's licking it gently with her raspy tongue. Ah! It doesn't hurt, it just feels really weird. It's like a miniature cat tongue under there, just like stroking my fingertip. So gross, Shrek, seriously. Shrek has a really interesting backstory. Shrek is actually a rescue pet of mine because she was found not by me, but she was found abandoned by a woman who was driving on the road. I think it was somewhere down in Kent, which is the south of England, and this woman came across this crate and pulled over because it was right in the middle of the road, and she didn't want to like hit it or anyone else to hit it because she was being really considerate, and she moved it, looked inside, and found a whole ton of baby snails. Now, baby snails, I will show you one nearer the end of this video, but they are so tiny they can balance on the tip of my finger and just disappear because they're so tiny. So she actually took them home and her husband raised them. They would give them baths and they would look after them, and Shrek grew to be one of the largest, not the largest, but one of the largest out of the clutch that she rescued. And she just had so many of them and was getting on a little bit in age, and she just needed someone else to take over their care. So I said that I would take on a couple of snails, which I have done, and Shrek actually doesn't just live at home with me now. I have had a big vivarium which I used to use for Shrek, but don't eat my finger. But I had to prioritize some other animals coming in, and at my workplace we've got the same size vivarium, so I just took her to my workplace. Now the people who kept Shrek before me were super kind people. I can't thank them enough for what they did for Shrek and the other snails, but they didn't have quite the same knowledge that other people who are more experienced with exotic animals have on how to care for snails, and they kind of bred out of control because these guys can lay hundreds of eggs at a time. If the environment is right, these guys are actually a pest in their native land in Africa because they can actually strip drywall. They are voracious eaters. They devour things in the right climate. And unfortunately, there wasn't enough calcium supplement being put into their diet. So they started eating each other's shells. So all the smaller baby snails would climb onto Shrek and rasp away with their tongues. So let me see if I can show you. So all of this here, that should be nice and smooth. In fact, I'm gonna show you what a healthy snail shell looks like. This is a healthier snail shell. This here's Delilah, and I actually raised Delilah from when she was absolutely tiny. Again, I don't know if Delilah is technically male or female. I mean, she's actually both, really. You can see her shell is just far superior in every way as compared to Shrek's shell. And these two are related. Delilah is the offspring of Shrek and my deceased snail, who's up here, the shell anyway. This over here is a smaller baby. It's a little bit shy, so hiding. And then if we want to go super crazy on tininess, do you see how tiny this little one is? You're too cute. Now these guys, if you were thinking of keeping them as pets, do bear in mind they do need high humidity. They do need to have a particular temperature, or you could lose them all just like that. If you are gonna keep them, I would recommend one snail, one, because you put two together and you're keeping them right, the likelihood is that these guys will breed. And when they start breeding, they don't really stop. But please be responsible if you are interested in a snail. Do your research, set them up properly. This is the underside of a snail. That's the underside of her foot. Hello! Have it. That is my rescue snail Shrek and her babies. I really, really hope that you enjoyed this video. I also just want to shout out really quickly and say a huge thank you so much to everybody that has subscribed to my channel. In the last week, my channel has just kind of expanded in ways that I didn't think it would. And you know, although the numbers are not in the millions, every single person means so much to me. Thank you all so much for watching. Please do subscribe to my channel. I've got some amazing videos coming up for you all. Have an awesome day, whatever you're doing, and I will catch you in another video soon. Bye!